Praise the Lord, my dear brothers and sisters. Welcome to the promises of God. Today, I will be talking about God's call to us all. According to Matthew chapter 28, verse 19 to 20, "Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptize in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to obey everything that I have commanded you. And remember, I am with you always to the end of the age." Brothers and sisters, before Jesus returned to heaven, he gave the disciples a command, which we call the Great Commission. In these verses, Jesus was commanding them to go out and make disciples. A disciple is someone who will follow their leader's instruction and does what he is told to do. So Jesus is telling his disciples to preach, teach, baptize, obey, do miracles and all the things that he did, and then have their students go out and do the same. And this would make them disciples of Jesus. Now, with that being said, though God's grace is persistent, if we turn down God, his grace may move to another person. Now, if we take the example of Saul, he was anointed king of Israel by God. But when he turned away from God, God's grace went and found another person. That was David. Similarly, with Israel, it was God's plan to bring them into the promised land. But after a great rebellion, God promised that generation would never enter the land, and they died in the wilderness. And instead, God gave the land to their children instead, and that too after 40 long years, brothers and sisters. Sometimes our rebellion forfeits God's original plan for our lives. It is possible to be disqualified. Paul said in 1 Corinthians chapter 9 verse 27, "But I punish my body and enslave it, so that after proclaiming to others, I myself should not be disqualified." Brothers and sisters, how are you responding to God's persistent grace? Scripture says that it is God's kindness that draws men to repentance, according to Romans chapter 2 verse 4. Let his persistent grace bring you to repentance, brothers and sisters, so that you can fulfill God's call on your life. But just be warned that today is the day of salvation, according to 2 Corinthians chapter 6 verse 2. We are not guaranteed tomorrow, and his grace may not persist in the same manner as today. So let us faithfully respond to God's persistent and loving grace, for this is our reasonable act of worship. In addition, God's call comes with many great promises. When God calls us or moves in our lives, many times he doesn't give us reasons or calm the ways of our curiosity. He may not answer questions like why or what for. Sometimes he doesn't even tell us where or how. But he always gives us promises, brothers and sisters. In the scripture, God gives conditional and unconditional promises. "I will never leave you nor forsake you" is an unconditional promise. "Give and it shall be given unto you" is a conditional promise. With Abraham, God seems to give a conditional promise that later becomes unconditional. In Genesis chapter 12, God says to him, "Leave, I will make you into a great nation and I will bless you." All of Abraham's promises were based on his obedience to God, brothers and sisters. So, when he commanded, his expectation was that everyone who heard the message of his disciples would become disciples too, and then in turn would make disciples who also made disciples. This is what God is calling us to do, to serve in this kingdom. The Great Commission was a command of Jesus Christ. So we don't have an option of whether to serve the Lord by reaching out and making disciples or not. Every Christian must do this if they are true disciples. Every Christian has a role in God's church. Our responsibility, brothers and sisters, is to ask God to show us how He wants us to serve Him and not if He wants us to serve Him. This is Sharon Bridget Mendonca from Kadosh Marian Ministries. God bless you all.